Hi, I'm Dorothy Hodder, and I'm on the third floor of the main library in the computer lab with Barbara Broadbeck. Barbara is here through a partnership that the library has with Cape Fear United Way. They got a grant for some stimulus money. And Barbara, please tell us about your grant project.
Well, our project is called Generations Online, and it's designed for people over 50 to become knowledgeable about computer use. And I teach very basic computer skills, and hopefully when they have tried a few times, they will be on the internet and exploring all the good things that are available.
What sorts of things do they find that they can do online?
Well, a lot of people want to learn how to email their grandchildren, and several people are here writing resumes and applying for jobs.
How long does it take for people to get comfortable if they come in and haven't touched a computer before? Have you seen people who haven't touched a computer
yes,
before?
Oh, yes. Yeah. There's one lady here today who is just barely learning, and she's only been here a couple of times, and so she needs to have some help. But she's doing very well.
And in two or three sessions, she'll feeling...
Oh, she'll be more comfortable.
Confident?
So I hope she'll be able to buy her own computer so she can work at home.
Wow. But if not, she can always come to the public library
right.
and use computers.
That's right.
So we're going to go into the lab and talk to some of the people who are here to work with Barbara today. Hi, Ms. Johnson. Thank you for talking with me today.
Oh,
I understand
it's a pleasure.
That you're a new student here in the computer lab. Is that right?
Yes.
And are you new to computers?
Not new to computers, but I come over to get some more extra, and I found out that Miss Barbara was here, and I looked her down in the library, and they found her for me. So I'm here to learn more different things about the computer.
Yes. Computers are pretty scary to tackle by yourself. What kind of help are you getting from Barbara?
Oh, I'm getting some gorgeous help from Miss Barbara. She is the sweetest woman I know. A teacher. She had to be a teacher in order to come here and do this with us. And it's so awesome.
Well, we think so too. What does it mean to you to have the library available to you so that you can come and learn?
Oh, it means a lot to have the library here for the elderly people. If all the elderly people would come out and just say, well, we are going down to the library and watch and do the computer with Miss Barbara, even when they learn, it would be a gorgeous thing.
Thank you so much, Ms. Johnson. Now I'm going to go downstairs and see what's going on in the reference department, talk to some more patrons. We're in the reference department on the first floor of the main library, and I'm talking with my friend Talia.
Hey.
Hi, Talia. Thank you for coming today.
You're welcome.
Talia, you got here from El Salvador a couple of years ago, is that right?
Yes, I came here back in August 2006, yes. And I have been visiting the library since then, and I have found the library very helpful.
I've met lots of people who come to the library when they're new in town. They've moved from somewhere far away. And they come to the library and find out what's going on in town and maybe meet some interesting people and get involved in some organizations. Have you had that experience?
Yes, that's right. When I was new here in town, I came to the library like every other day, and I met wonderful people, and I knew about all these events in the area. So it was very nice, very nice, yes.
And I know Wilmington's a tough town to find a job in, and you've told me that you work 20 jobs or 50 jobs. And,
yeah, something
and
like
what
that.
What kind of work are you putting together?
What I do, I teach Spanish and English, and I teach to professionals, to children, to any kind of people that wants to learn the language. And anytime that I wanted some kind of material, I came to the library, and I found very nice resources, and yeah, it really helped me a lot.
We have materials you can refer your students to work on for their homework.
Yeah, that's right. Every time I was like, okay, you need to go to the library and ask for this book, and that's going to help you with your homework, and your grammar and everything. So yeah,
yeah,
it's a very helpful place to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to thank you so much for coming in and talking with us today about what we've got here that using for your
Yeah, you're welcome. And yeah, thank you for having this great place too.
Thanks again, Talia. It's great talking with you, and I always love seeing you in the library. Let's just walk over and have a look in the reference section at a few more resources that we have for people who are job hunting and continuing their education. I've worked in this library for almost 25 years, and when I started, it was all these books were what we had to offer. As we've seen today, we have a whole lot more now. A lot of what we have to offer is online. We even have tutors and a tutoring service that's available for live chat with students and job hunters 24/7 through our webpage. We have tutorials online, as well as Barbara upstairs helping people to get comfortable using the computers. We see a lot of students who are continuing their education and coming here to have their online exams proctored. I'm even in school myself and taking a class online and using some of these resources like NC Live and Interlibrary Loan and the reference books as a student myself. In spite of the changes in technology that I've seen in 25 years here, what we do is still the same, and it's still very satisfying. We help people find the information they need and learn the skills they need to learn to keep up in a world that's changing very quickly and sometimes not in directions that we're comfortable with right away. The library's a great place to work because we're helping people every day find the information they need for their life, for their work, for whatever it is that's important to them. And I hope that I'll see you here in the library soon. Thank you for joining me.